Hello students, in this lecture I will be discussing about the Jordan canonical forms. In the previous lecture we discussed how to find minimal polynomial once we know the characteristic polynomial. Now the Jordan blocks are of the form G of lambda, where the diagonals are filled with the eigenvalue of the matrix lambda, and the diagonal above the principal diagonal, also called as the super diagonals, are filled with the element 1. The rest of the matrix are filled with zeros. So this line is called the principal this line is called the super diagonal, and we have 1. Now you can see this as a matrix formed by lambda I plus n of r, where n of r is the nilpotent matrix lambda into this would be the identity matrix here, plus so here n of r is the nilpotent matrix which has 1s only in the super diagonal, that is the diagonal above the principal diagonal. Now if we have t from v to v, a linear transformation with the characteristic polynomial t minus lambda 1 power n 1, t minus lambda 2 power n 2, t minus lambda r power n r. Now V is a matrix, is a vector space of dimension n, but here we have taken only r, because lambda 1, lambda 2 up to lambda r are the distinct eigenvalues. So the characteristic polynomial will be t minus lambda 1 power m 1, t minus lambda 2 power m 2, and up to t minus lambda r power n r. Since the total number of eigenvalues should be equal to dimension of the vector space, we should have n1 plus n2 plus n3 up to nr should be equal to dimension of the vector space V. Now coming back to the theorem, if T is a linear transformation from V to V with delta of T as characteristic polynomial, m of T as the minimal polynomial, then there exists a representation J, then there exist a diagonal matrix representation J whose diagonal blocks are J J I J of lambda. for each lambda I, the properties of each jij for each lambda I are as follows. Now, if you look at, say, lambda 1, for that, the degree of t minus lambda 1 in the minimal polynomial is m1. Therefore, there should be at least one block jij of order mi. So if I take lambda 1, at least one block should be of size m1, and for the same lambda we can have more than one block, but the size should be less than or equal to m1. The sum of orders of jij is equal to ni. So if I take lambda 1, I should write n1 in terms of m1 and factors less than m1. So some k times mi plus li should be equal to ni, where li is a number between 0 and mi. The third point is, the number of jijs for each lambda I is equal to the geometric multiplicity. Of lambda I. The geometric multiplicity I'll be explaining in the next section. The number of jijs for each of each possible order is uniquely determined by T. To understand geometric multiplicity, let us take this example that was discussed earlier. For this matrix, we found that the eigenvalues are 2, 2 and 3. Now the 3 is a distinct eigenvalue, and hence the geometric multiplicity of 3 is 1, because we write delta of t equal to t minus 2 whole squared into t minus 3. So the algebraic multiplicity of the eigenvalue 3 is 1, and the algebraic multiplicity of t minus 2, that is the eigenvalue 2, is 2. Now to understand geometric multiplicity, we need to look at the eigenspace corresponding to the repeated eigenvalue. For the repeated eigenvalue, the power of the factor in the characteristic polynomial will be the algebraic multiplicity. For the geometric multiplicity, we look at the number of eigenvectors corresponding to that eigenvalue. So here we found only one independent eigenvector, that is 1 0 0, and the others are all multiples of 1 0 0. Therefore, lambda equal to 2 has geometric multiplicity 1. Now similarly, if you look at the other example, A equal to 2, 1, minus 2, 2, 3, minus 4, 1, 1, minus 1, the eigenvalues were 2, 1, 1. So the characteristic polynomial was t minus 2 into t minus 1 whole squared. So we have algebraic multiplicity of the eigenvalue 1 to be 2. Now, the eigenspace corresponding to lambda equal to 1 was C1 into minus 1, 1, 0 plus C2 into 2, 0, 1. Since we have two independent eigenvectors corresponding to lambda equal to 1, geometric multiplicity of lambda equal to 1 is 2. So the number of eigenvectors, independent eigenvectors for a repeated eigenvalue determines the geometric multiplicity of the eigenvalue. So we consider this problem: find the Jordan canonical form of the linear transformation whose characteristic polynomial is t minus 2 power 4 minus into t minus 5 cube, and minimal polynomial is t minus 2 squared into t minus 5 cube. Now we find here that t minus 2 whole power 4 can be written in terms of the maximum power allowed for the factors here is 2, because the minimal polynomial has power 2. So at least one Jordan block should be of order 2. Therefore, we write t minus 2 whole power 4 in two possible ways. So when we write like this, it means we can have two Jordan blocks for of order 2 each, or we can write this as t minus 2 whole squared into t minus 2 into t minus 2. These are the possible ways of writing t minus 2 whole power 4, which is a factor of the characteristic polynomial. So we see one factor at least of order 2 by observing the minimal polynomial is written. The others can be again in terms of power 2 or lesser than that. But when we take t minus 5 whole cube, because the minimal polynomial has t minus 5 whole cube, we have only one possible option, that is to return it as t minus 5 whole cube. So we have two cases here where we write delta of t as t minus 2 whole squared into t minus 2 whole squared into t minus 5 whole cube. This would be case 1. Case 2 is delta of t being written as t minus 2 whole squared into t minus 2 into t minus 2 into t minus 5 whole cube. Now the first case results when we have for lambda equal to 2, we have two independent eigenvectors. The second case results when lambda equal to 2 has three independent eigenvectors. Now for lambda equal to 5, there is only one eigenvector. Therefore, only one Jordan block is written for lambda equal to 5. Now case 1, delta of t is t minus 2 squared, t minus 2 squared, t minus 5 cube. So for t minus 2 squared, we write J11 equal to the eigenvalue is 2, so 2's along the diagonal and 1 in the super diagonal, the remaining element is 0. For t minus 5 whole cube, J12 again for lambda equal to 2 will be, sorry, in this case lambda equal to 5 will be, because we have a cubic polynomial, this should be of order 3 with diagonal along the diagonal we write the eigenvalue 5, in the super diagonal we write 1 and zeros in the remaining places. Therefore, one possible representation of the Jordan canonical form would have J11 0 0 J22, which is (2, 1, 0, 2). This would be the first block. Here we will have zeros, then another block, with 2, 1, 0, 2, and the last block would be, here we will have zeros again, so the remaining places are all filled with zero blocks. So this matrix J will have the same characteristic polynomial and minimal polynomial as the given linear transformation. Now case 2 would be delta of t written as t minus 2 squared, t minus 2, t minus 2, t minus 5 whole cube. So t minus 2 corresponds to J12, that is for a linear polynomial, So since there is only one block corresponding to the second eigenvalue, so this should be represented as J21. But all these Jordan blocks occupy the diagonal of the matrix J. So since we have already found the Jordan block corresponding to lambda equal to 5, we write J as J11, J12, J13, which all correspond to lambda equal to 2, and J21, which corresponds to lambda equal to 5. The remaining entries of this matrix J are zeros. So if we recollect the definition or the theorem, we find looking at the minimal polynomial, we see that there is a t minus 2 whole squared in minimal polynomial. Therefore, the two possible ways of writing characteristic polynomial are t minus 2 whole squared into t minus 2 whole squared into t minus 5 whole cube. No other possible factors of t minus 5 are whole cube are written because the minimal polynomial has t minus 5 whole cube. And according to the theorem, at least one block should be there of order 3 for lambda equal to 5. Therefore, only one possible way of writing t minus 5 whole cube. Whereas for t minus 2 whole raised to 4, we can write it as t minus 2 whole squared into t minus 2 whole squared, or t minus 2 squared into t minus 2 into t minus 2. So we have, for the first case, the Jordan block given by this. It is not necessary. Here I have missed one representation, J11, because there are two factors, there should be one more block of the same size. There should be J12. This is corresponding to lambda equal to 2, lambda equal to 2. This is J21, which corresponds to lambda equal to 5. The remaining entries are zeros. Therefore, if we fill up J11, J12 and J21, this is what we are going to end up with. And when we have characteristic polynomial expressed as t minus 2 whole squared, t minus 2 into t minus 2 into t minus 5 whole cube, we have four Jordan blocks. The first block is of size 2 because of t minus 2 whole squared. J12 and J13 are blocks of size 1 cross 1, and J21 corresponding to lambda equal to 5 is a 3 cross 3 block. We will choose another example where the linear transformation T from V to V has characteristic polynomial to be T minus 2 power 5 and minimal polynomial is t minus 2 whole squared. Now, depending on how we express t minus 2 whole power 5 in terms of t minus 2 squared, we can have that many possible Jordan canonical forms. So, delta of t can be written as t minus 2 whole squared, t minus 2 whole squared into t minus 2, which adds up to t minus 2 power 5, or t minus 2 whole squared, t minus 2, t minus 2 into t minus 2. So we have two possible cases. The first case corresponds to lambda equal to 2 having 3 eigenvectors. The second case corresponds to lambda equal to 2 having 4 eigenvectors. one for each possible factor that we have written. So case 1, delta of t is t minus 2 squared, t minus 2 squared, t minus 2. So we need to have 3 Jordan blocks corresponding to lambda equal to 2. Now t minus 2 whole squared corresponds to J11. This is equal to 2102. Since we have 2 factors of degree 2, I should have 2 blocks of second order and 1 factor of degree 1. Therefore, this will be, for the linear factor, we have a 1 cross 1 block. So case 1 will have J to be of the form J11, J12, J13, where 11 and 12 are 2 cross 2 blocks and 13 is a 1 cross 1 block. Now case 2, we have characteristic polynomial expressed as t minus 2 whole squared into t minus 2 into t minus 2 into t minus 2. Therefore, we have J11 in this case equal to 2102, which corresponds to t minus 2 whole squared, and J12, J13, and J14 all will have a 1 cross 1 block corresponding to the linear factor t minus 2. So the second case results in the diagonal block representation to be of the form J11, J12, J13, J14. The rest are all zeros. Now if we add up the orders of each of the blocks, it will be equal to the degree of the characteristic polynomial.